Okay, so the last topic for today is like multi-threading in Java. Okay, so in multi-threading, we have seen so many concepts of threading in the last class. Okay, for the newcomers, maybe you can watch the previous video about threading concepts. We have seen about the life cycles of threads, then the types of implementation of threads, like that we have seen. Now we will see something called multi-threading, and we will see what are the problems that are associated with multi-threading and how we can overcome that problems with the help of like some concepts like that we will see. So now I will share my whiteboard with you. Can you all able to see my whiteboard? Can you all able to see my whiteboard? Yeah, okay. So multi-threading is nothing but if we have more than one thread, then we can call that as multi-threaded environment. Assuming there is a diagram here in which we have two threads, namely thread 1 and thread 2. It is accessing the common memory, okay? And these two threads can have read as well as write operation. Okay, so now what happens is if thread 1 writes some data, okay, if thread 1 writes some data, then it will write some content, maybe in memory it will write some content. Okay, after writing the content, if the thread 2 reads the data, there won't be any problem. Okay, because after the completion of write, the read operation is done by thread 2. Similarly, if thread 1 and thread 2 performs the read operation at the same time, it won't perform any problem. But what happens if thread 1 performs read operation and thread 2 performs write operation at the same time? Or in a vice versa, like thread 1 is performing if thread 1 is performing some write operation and thread 2 is performing read operation, okay, that means there will be a inconsistent in the data. Okay, so there will be some inconsistent in the data. For example, if thread 1 is writing some data, for example it is modifying x value as from 10 to 20, but at the same time if thread 2 is reading the data, it will not be consistent, that we will not make sure that it is reading the correct data. So there must be some consistency when we go for some multi-threaded environment. So what we will do is we will create an application in multi-threaded environment, and we will execute that, and we will see like some improper execution of that thread because of there is no coordination between the thread. And we will see some of the solution to avoid such kind of stuffs like that. Okay, so now I will just close this white board. Now, can you able to see my notepad, everyone? Can you able to see my notepad? Okay, fine. So now, what I am going to do is I am going to create one common, like I'm going to start with a very basic program. Like I'm going to create a common resource. The common resource, it's similar to a memory, okay? It's similar to a memory, okay? So the main purpose of this common resource is to generate a table. For example, if you give 2, it will generate a 2 table. If you give 4, it will generate a 4 table. Like that, it will generate. Okay, so this is a common resource, and we have two threads, namely like thread 1, which performs the second table execution, and thread 2, which performs the fourth table execution. That means this thread 1 will execute the second table, like 2 into 2, so 2 into 1, 2, 2 into 2, 2, 2 into 2, 4, like that it will execute up to 10. Similarly, this thread 2 will execute up to 4, okay? And we will have a main program so that we will execute both threads simultaneously, and we will just check how it is going to be done. Okay, so I will repeat this again. So we are going to create a common resource called table. The main purpose of this table is to generate a table, whatever may be in input. If you give input as 2, it will generate a 2 table. If you give input as 4, it will generate a 4 table. And we are going to create a 2 thread. Maybe thread 1 is for processing a second table, and thread 2 is for processing the fourth table. And the main program is to execute the 2 threads simultaneously like that. Okay. So I'm going to write the program. So let me create a folder. Let me create a folder, multi-thread. Okay, for our understanding, then I will create a new text document. So I will rename it as main thread dot Java. Okay, so what I will do is I will create main thread. So this is a main program. Public static void main string args like that. Then I am going to create 2 threads. So thread maybe thread 1, so thread 2 or thread 1 maybe I should use, or you can simply use 2 table class 4 table like that. And I am going to create a class table which will perform the table operation. For example, the table operation will be public void generate table, maybe we could say. Then it will get t number, that is the table number. If you pass 2, it will print 2 table. If you pass 4, it will print 4 table like that. So to do that, we'll use a for loop for int I equal to 1, I less than 10, I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus. Okay, so I'm going to print that. So what I'm going to do that, I'm going to create a thread dot sleep, because I'm going to watch each and every step with some time delay. So I will use thread dot sleep. So if I want to use thread.sleep, I should use this try catch mechanism. We have already seen this. Okay. So in try, what I will do is I will make thread.sleep to maybe for 1000 milliseconds. Then after that, I will print the content system.out.println. So each and every time I will multiply I with t number, so that if I pass 2 into 1, 2 into 1, 2 into 2, 2 into 3 like that, it will print. So if there is any problem, it will call the exception. Like that, assuming this is the common memory. Okay, the main purpose of this is to generate a table. Whatever it comes, if you pass 2, it will generate 2 table. If you pass 4, it will generate 4 table like that. So whatever it will do, this will be a common resource. Okay, or it's like memory. We'll see another program so that you will easily understand the thing. So we'll start with the basic one and we'll go for the advanced one. So class table, we'll generate a table. The generate table method is like this. We'll generate a table with a time delay of 100 milliseconds. Now we are going to create a thread to table So it's a thread, so it must extends a predefined table thread. Similarly, class for table, it should extends predefined thread like that. So now this two table and four table must access this common table, right? So for that I will create something like table t like that, and I will pass this to a constructor to table. So I will pass this to the constructor public to table, then I will pass the table t here. Again, you can see the variable here is I have created object. Here also I am passing the object. I have the same name like t and t. So I have to use this dot t equal to t semicolon. Then I will use method public void run method. It's a thread method to run that. So what I will do is I will use t dot generate table. T dot generate table of two. Okay. So similarly, I will do it for the four table also. So first I will use the common resource table, and I will pass that to a constructor. For table, table t, then t dot this dot t equal to t, then public void run t dot generate table. Instead of two, I will give four like that. So then I will save this as main demo dot java. It's already saved. Now what you see is I have created a common table where this thread two table as well as the four table, which uses this common table to generate its own table. For example, t dot generate table, which we specified inside the run method. So it will generate a two table for us. Similarly, four table, it will generate a four table for us. Now in main program, so I have to create an object for three things like table t equal to new table, then to table t2 equal to new to table. Then for table t4 equal to new for table. Now we have to start this thread. Okay, so how I can start this thread? I can use we have two threads like t2 and t4, and we have a method like run method. How we can do that? So we can execute this run method with help of the start thing. So t2 dot start and then t4 dot start. I am executing the thread simultaneously or parallelly so that you will see some execution. So let me copy the location. So Java C star dot Java. Oh, I think there is some issue. We'll just check. Okay. I forgot to pass this thing. Because since we are using this kind of thing, we have to pass the table T here, so that both T2 and T4 will use this common T table to execute its functionalities. So I will run this. Oh, what is that? Sorry, it's main thread. So now what we'll do is it is printing two table, then four table like that. Now what is the output we are getting is like we are getting an improper result. The thing is like either one thread, like if it is a common memory, if there are multiple thread, like at most only one thread can able to perform the operation. But what you are seeing here is first it is executing thread 2, then it is executing thread 4, again it is executing thread 2, then thread 4, thread 2, thread 4, like that it is executing. So this is an example for improper execution. See for the second output. So it will execute the fourth table first, then second table again. There is like mix up thing and it is executing. Even if I execute again, so it will again start with four table, then executing the second table. Like it mix ups everything and it is giving the result. Similarly, if there is like if more than two threads shares the memory, this is how the result will be. It will be the inconsistent one. Okay, so to avoid this inconsistency, we have to apply some strategy. Okay, so like I think you have studied the operating system in your studies. Like if there is any deadlock, how will you prevent that particular deadlock? You can type in your chat. If there is any deadlock, how will you prevent a deadlock? How will you prevent a deadlock? So there are many mechanisms available, maybe round robin mechanisms available. What is this round robin thing? So this, I'm not asking about the algorithm. I'm just asking about the concept. What is the concept you will use to avoid the inconsistency in multi-threading? What is the method to avoid inconsistency in multiple threading? Or dash is used to avoid deadlock? Or which mechanism is used to avoid deadlock? So the answer for this is like, so which is the which class actually the thread 2 table and 4 table is using? Here we have four classes, like class table, class 2 table, class 4 table and main thread. So which we have two thread, we came to know that we have two threads like 2 table and 4 table like that. Now can you just tell me which class both thread 1 and thread 2 are sharing? So we can see the table is the class in which thread 2 table as well as 4 table is sharing. Now we have to make sure that this method or this class will be controlled, or this method should be synchronized. So what you can do is, so before void, you can put something called synchronized keyword. So if you put synchronized keyword before this generate table, what it will do is it will allow only one thread to access this table. For example, if I compile it, if I run it, now you see first the thread 4 will be executed. Then followed by 2 like that. Now there is some consistency. So again, if I run, now the thread 2 is executing first. There is no mix up and all. First, the complete 2 table is executed, followed by the 4 table. So if I again execute, you will see some first the 4 table is executed and followed by 2 table like that. So this is how we can provide consistency in a multiple threading environment. The consistency is nothing but we have to make sure that the shared method must be synchronized. If you use synchronized keyword, it will allow only one thread to access at a time. After execution of that particular thread, it will allow other thread to be get executed. Okay, let me explain this program again. So I have created a common class called table, in which so I'm just deleting this synchronized, so that first I will explain the concept. So I use a common memory, maybe say I will use table. This table will generate a table, okay, and for the animation, for time delay, I will use thread dot sleep to 1000 millisecond. Okay, so I will just print whatever input you are giving to this generate table. It will generate the table for you, and this is the logic. And so we will use thread 1 and thread 2. So thread 1, the main purpose of thread 1 is to generate two table, and the main purpose of thread 2 is to generate a four table for us. This thread 2 table, which should use this table T, it should use this table T to generate its content. So I am passing that to the four table constructor. So I'm just passing that as the object. So this object and this object are same. So I will use this dot t equal to t. Then I will use run method, because we know that thread can be executed by overriding the run method. So using this t dot generate table of four, t dot generate table of two will execute the two table in this table. After that, I'm doing the fourth table in the same way. Similarly, I'm creating an object for every classes. So I'm going to pass this T object for two table, because in the constructor we are getting that the table T. Similarly, I'm passing T for four table also, four table as well as two table. And I'm starting this thread 2 and thread 4 with t2.start and t4.start. So now, without synchronization, if you execute that, you will see some there is some mix up in the execution. Sorry, I think I need to compile it. Wait, let me wait for the execution. Yeah, I need to compile it. I need to run it. You'll see first 2, then 4, 8, 4, like that. There is some inconsistency in the data. That means if both the threads are accessing the memory at the same time, and it's providing some inconsistency, and we are getting some improper result. So to make them to be consistent, we have to convert this into be synchronized, so that the whole process can be synchronized with the help of this simple keyword called synchronized. We have to make sure that, because this generate table is going to execute, so we have to make sure that this will be synchronized. So again, let me compile it. Let me execute it. You see, first the four table is getting executed. Like that, and then followed by second table. Or if you run that, the second table first get executed, fourth table. This provides some consistency in the execution. Okay, so this is all about multi-threading. When we have a multi-threaded environment, we will have some inconsistency in the data. To avoid the inconsistency, we should use the synchronized keyword. So in the operating system, you would have learned like synchronization is the process of preventing the deadlock. So similarly, when there is any inconsistency in multiple threading, multi-threading, we'll use the term synchronized. So any doubt in this? Any doubt? So any doubt in this multi-threading? Maybe you can ask. Any doubt? Okay, so let me create another application. Okay, let me create another application, or we'll just modify this. So I'm going to use, instead of table, I'm going to use memory for our understanding. Instead of table, I'm going to use memory, and public synchronized, so I'm going to take that out. So public, so instead of generate table, I will use something called generate action, or I can put operation. So for example, in the memory, I'm going to perform the operation like string op. So if the operation is read, it will print for maybe like 10 times, because we are using for loop. For example, if I pass the operation as read, it will execute read for the 10 time. If I pass the operation as write, it will pass write as the operation, like that. So similarly, the same thing we'll use. So so like two table, instead of two table, I can put it as reader. So reader, and I'm going to just delete this one. So we have to use the memory M. Then we have to pass the constructor public reader memory M, like that. Then this dot M equal to M. Then we have to use public void run. So then we have to use m dot method name is generate operation. M dot generate operations, I will put that as a read. Now similarly, I'm going to overwrite, I'm going to modify to for the writer also. So writer, and I'm going to pass the messages write. So I'm going to create an object for memory. M is equal to new memory. Then reader R equal to new reader. So we have to pass this M. Then writer W equal to new writer of W. Then we have to start that R dot start W dot start. So what I did is I have created a common memory where two threads are there. One is to perform read, and one is to like perform read, and another is to perform write. What happens if we execute read and write like parallelly or concurrently? You will have like inconsistency in doing that. So if you compile, okay, so W, I think we have to pass M. So let me run it. So now you see is first it is read, then write, read, write, read, write, read, write, write, like that. So this will make the memory more inconsistent. So what we can do is, if you convert this into synchronized, if you convert this into synchronized, it will allow only one operation to be performed at a time. Synchronized, I think it's not S, it is Z. So now you see, first all the read operations will be executed. It allows the reader to execute first. Then after completion of read, it is allowing a writer to execute the write operation. Or the vice versa. First it will execute write, then it will execute read, like that. because we are not set any priority, so it takes a default priority and it is executing randomly like threads, but with a consistency in doing that. So this is all about multi-threading, and we can provide a multi-threaded environment safe and secure with the help of a synchronized keyword. So as like final, we can say that synchronization is process of preventing a deadlock. Okay. So any doubt in this?